Nitric Oxide, Part 3. Welcome to the third and final lecture in the Biology of Nitric Oxide series. Again, my name is Joseph Giacalone. I'm a research scientist at Genysis Nutritional Labs, and I'm your host for these lectures. Uncoupling of the enzyme, which we discussed in Part 2 of these lectures, can be prevented in three ways. The first way is to increase the amount of tetrahydrobiopterin, or BH4, concentration in the body. There are some problems in doing so, because tetrahydrobiopterin cannot be increased by supplementing. Its production and fate is tightly regulated in the body. It is also financially prohibitive to supplement with tetrahydrobiopterin at this time because of the cost of the supplement. However, research has shown that folic acid, a B vitamin, is chemically similar to BH4, and it can be used to fill the space the limited supply of tetrahydrobiopterin usually has to fill. The name of folic acid, the active ingredient, is tetrahydrofolate, as opposed to tetrahydrobiopterin. These chemicals are so similar that they fit in the same receptor, and the NOS enzyme can use them interchangeably as a cofactor to stimulate the enzyme. Also, tetrahydrofolate has the capacity to basically recycle BH4 after it has been oxidized, so that it can be used multiple times in the NOS enzyme. Its ability to stand in for BH4 and to recycle oxidized BH4 makes folic acid the perfect solution to problems with the uncoupling of the NOS enzyme and in helping it to function at or above normal efficiency. The second way uncoupling can be prevented is by increasing the conversion of citrulline to arginine. In the second lecture, we talked about two pools of L-arginine, one that is connected to oral consumption and the other that is not affected by supplementation. This second pool is not connected to the extracellular sources, so taking large amounts of L-arginine does not affect the concentration of L-arginine in pool number two. Pool number two is converted back and forth from citrulline to arginine continuously, and some of the citrulline is transported to the surface and released in the extracellular environment, or transferred in and out of the mitochondria for further use. In this illustration, we show that free L-arginine, or pool number one of L-arginine, that is affected by oral supplementation. Increasing oral supplementation simply siphons free L-arginine into the arginase pathway. This produces polyamines and does not produce nitric oxide. However, citrulline, the byproduct of nitric oxide production, is reconverted to L-arginine in pool number two. It is important to remember that pool number two is not connected to the extracellular environment, but recent research shows that taking citrulline orally does increase pool number two for L-arginine by supplying it with more citrulline to convert into L-arginine. The cycle of citrulline's conversion to L-arginine is continuous and does not affect pool number one. The third way uncoupling can be prevented is by preventing the breakdown of nitric oxide. Nitric oxide is a free radical. It is highly reactive and will react with other free radicals, hydroxyls, nitroxyls, and superoxides, and many other chemicals. These reactions will lower the concentration of nitric oxide in the body and thus prevent its effects. You can prevent the breakdown of nitric oxide simply by adding antioxidants. In this illustration, we have nitric oxide shown as a diatomic gas, and around it we have oxygen-free radicals. The green signs are symbolic of antioxidants. As the antioxidants increase in concentration, they block the O2 radicals, and without the reaction to destroy them, nitric oxide levels increase. A simple addition of antioxidants, whether it is vitamin C, vitamin E, alpha-lipoic acid, L-carnitine, etc., increases the half-life of nitric oxide, not by increasing production, but by salvaging what nitric oxide is produced by preventing the O2 radical from destroying it. In this alternative scheme for nitric oxide production, we see the TriFlow technology at work by producing nitric oxide. In the original demonstration, in part one of the lectures, I showed that the proper function of the NOS enzyme requires NADPH, O2, tetrahydrobiopterin, or BH4, and L-arginine. When we use TriFlow to enhance the body's ability to produce nitric oxide, we replace BH4 with folic acid and L-arginine with citrulline. These substitutions allow smooth transfer of electrons across the enzyme as if you had BH4 and L-arginine. When electrons are allowed to pass through smoothly, the enzyme can function normally and create nitric oxide. Studies have shown that the TriFlow formula allows the NOS enzyme to function at or above normal efficiency, giving your body increased amounts of nitric oxide. Up to this point in these lectures, I've talked mostly about how nitric oxide is created in the body, and how we at Genysis Nutritional Labs have found a way to supplement the material your body needs to make nitric oxide more efficiently. Now I'd like to discuss some of the benefits of nitric oxide. Nitric oxide is the key to increased blood flow to muscles and organs. When you're working out or using your muscles, they require specific nutrients found in the blood to do the exercise and to grow. The increased blood flow to your body needs for energy and growth is provided by nitric oxide. It was recently discovered that because nitric oxide upregulates genes in your muscle cells, nitric oxide can actually stimulate and increase metabolism, which in turn stimulates muscles to grow more quickly. It functions as an antioxidant in the body. The increased supply of blood and nutrients to your muscles increases your endurance. Nitric oxide can reduce the process of atherosclerosis, which is the hardening and thickening of your arteries, because of its ability to expand blood vessels and increase blood flow. It has been shown to stabilize blood clotting, especially in people whose blood clots more easily than normal. These are just some of the benefits of nitric oxide. There's a whole new area of nitric oxide research opening up that will likely increase our understanding in many ways of how nitric oxide can help our bodies. Thank you for joining us for this, the third and final discussion about the science behind nitric oxide and its role in your body. If you would like to learn more, go to gnlabs.net. to evaluate these lectures further and to find more information about our patented TriFlow technology.